Hey, how's it going, everybody? BurntBrian here. Welcome back to another Tall Can Tuesday. In this video series, I like to give you guys channel updates, give some shout outs, talk about some random topics and answer questions submitted by you, and of course, drink some beer. And the way I've been doing this is one week I'll feature a craft beer, the following week will be a malt beverage of some kind, because I try to keep the balance between the two worlds. And since last week I took a look at Terrapin's The Walking Dead Blood Orange IPA, which was awesome. It was really, really good and a super cool label. This week we're going to be taking a look at King Cobra and the 32 ounce, because that's all I got, and the nice big glass bottle here. And so this one says new look, same taste. I actually remember the old label style because we used to sell a whole bunch of this at one of the gas stations that I was managing when I was like 18 years old. No, I think I was 19 at the time. But this one's at 6% per volume, and it says it's premium malt liquor with a smooth taste. And we'll see about that. So let's go ahead and get this party started here. And what do we got? I can't open it. There we go. All right. I guess we'll go ahead and take a swig off of this thing before I get started on some questions and some things that you guys had put in a couple of my last videos and some Facebook posts. But salud. That is super cold, like hurt my teeth, super ice cold, but definitely really refreshing and smooth malt liquor, definitely one of the smoother ones. Not a big fan of Colt 45 at all, just kind of has this thickness to it that I'm not a fan of. This is actually nice and refreshing here, but what I wanted to start out with was I looked through some of the last videos and just kind of got some questions and some things that maybe some of you had thrown up there, and just to answer them real quick, we've got CB Fall. If you haven't noticed, I've got this whole green screen thing kicking. I kind of like this background. I'll probably be using it in several of my videos just because I think it's cool. It goes, it's different. And maybe I'll use some other stock footage that I get here and there of different random events that I might be doing. So, I might have some of the mud bogging video and stuff going on in the background, see some of the beautiful trails in Florida while I talk about certain things. Just to kind of keep things different and, it's just something different than what everybody else is doing, and I kind of like that. So, he had said, CB Fall said, loving the awesome fireplace background. Will this be in most of your videos? And so, like I just said, yes, this will more than likely be in a lot of my videos. Probably not all of them, because I like to keep things random and kind of switch it up every now and then. But I do like it. You guys let me know down below, do you like the green screen effect? Is it kind of cool? Do you like me playing around with this a little bit, maybe changing some of the background? Let me know. Also, Lost Ways, he said, any holiday drinks coming out that you enjoy, maybe an eggnog recipe or suggestions? And actually, that is one of my favorite things about this time of year, was when I actually just the other day saw eggnog in the grocery store, and I was like, yes, because I do love eggnog, always have for some reason. And I never really got into the alcoholic versions of those until maybe a few years back, so I might be able to share some recipes. I know one thing that I was thinking about maybe showing you guys was how to make some of the rum balls the way that I do. Because those things are always fun during the holiday season. Just about every holiday party I've ever been to had rum balls and alcoholic eggnog. So definitely be looking out for something like that. Good questions, man. And we've also got Rudy Sauceda. He's a friend of mine on Facebook. And he said, he was asking me, why don't I try to compare drinks like Four Loko and Juice, beers of that nature in my Tall Can Tuesdays. And that's not a bad idea at all. I've actually had been looking at some of those in the store the other day because they're just really, I'm kind of like wondering, well, what am I going to do? There's only so many of these malt liquors that I can find in my store, speaking of. But my front tooth is really sore off of this ice cold drink. I never have any sensitivity in my teeth from drinking, or from eating anything hot or cold. I'm kind of thinking, well, what am I going to do? There's only so many of these things that I can find to drink. And so I kind of been looking at some of the Four Loko ones as an option to what I could do after, I get through all of the ones I can find locally. And maybe I can talk some of the guys out here in the YouTube drinking community. If you can find some of the ones that I can't, I would love to get my hands on some. Like the one in particular I've really been wanting to get on a few different flavors is St. Ides, and I can't find those anywhere. And man, St. Ides were what I grew up on. It was like every weekend we would have somebody go and pick us up quarts of those. And I think my favorite was probably the fruit punch. It was just such a easy, smooth flavor. I want to say there was maybe a green. I don't know if it was a sour apple that I wasn't a fan of. Yeah, I don't know. Anyway. So if you do happen to have St. Ides in your area, let me know. I would love to, like I say, get a hold of a couple of the different flavors of those. That was just such a good fruity, you know, beer back in the day. I mean, I don't know why I liked fruity beers back then, but hell, you could get, I don't even know what the alcohol content was. I just know you could get two of those and get pretty hammered. And it was a pretty nasty hangover the next day. Also, this isn't a question or a topic or anything like that, but one of my friends, Amanda, she was a former coworker of mine, and she's been real supportive of what I do, making these videos and all. And she had actually said that she went out and bought Not Your Father's Root Beer after watching the review I did for Coney Island's Hard Root Beer. And you know, she said I was spot on in the comparison. And Ted Barris said the same thing in one of his Unplugged videos. And I thought that's really cool. It's awesome when I can do this and people, you know, take my word on something and go out and try it. And they say, wow, that was exactly what you said it was going to be. And I really appreciate that a lot. I really did think that Coney's Island was more thick and syrupy, you know, and kind of had more of that alcohol taste to it, whereas Not Your Father's Root Beer was just smooth, easy drinking, you know, almost like watery. It was just so simple to drink and get a good buzz on. But anyway, that's awesome. Thanks, Amanda. I appreciate it. She also even offered to, I think she's got a stout from Dogfish that she might be handing off to me at some time, and that's really awesome. I appreciate that. I always look forward to trying new beers. But that's all I have from the videos, except I did have one or two other things that I wanted to bring up real quick. Let me take another swig. So, let's see. Oh, we've got Francisco F. He's been watching and commenting on several of my videos recently. He's got a lot of good suggestions for me, so definitely keep them coming. I really appreciate the support, man. But he said, maybe you could do an everyday man beer pairing with a food review, whether it be something you made or picked up. And this is a really good idea where he goes with all this. Kill two reviews at once and set yourself apart kind of thing. Even hot sauce and fast food pairings, like say review some new chicken sandwich from Wendy's, pair it with a hot sauce for extra kick, and pick a beer to go with it. And that's just you know, he said he's never seen anything like that, and neither have I. So I think that's like it's a genius suggestion. I really do appreciate that. That's something that I will be looking into, and I've already kind of come up with a couple ideas for how I want to do that. It would be hard to me. I guess I would have to pick a couple different hot sauces and a couple different beers that I think would go well with something before trying it. It's always hard, I guess, when you're like when people are genuinely doing food pairings. A lot of times, like, they'll know what the flavors are beforehand, whereas most of the hot sauces I try when I do reviews for those, it's kind of a blind test so that, you know, you're getting my first reaction, my first thoughts and opinions. I haven't had time to rehearse anything or, you know, write a script or anything about it. You're just getting my raw input, what I think about it right away. But I think I could do something like you're suggesting, especially with sauces that I've already tried and used. I can go back and get a new food item, pair it with that, and just kind of take a couple different beers, different styles of beers, set them out in front of me, and then kind of, you know, just take bites of the food and kind of go from there and figure out, you know, which beer I think would go best with this meal and crack it open and give it a try. If it doesn't work the first time, crack open another one. Definitely a great suggestion, man. I really appreciate that, and I will definitely be looking into doing something like that here soon. Let's see. Also, don't forget, I do have a collaboration coming up here soon with the Beer Chasers. Sometime in November, we're going to be taking a look at a couple of different beers. And starting sometime this week, I'll have, I'm not sure when exactly, because I know I've got another hot sauce review, and I think that's about it. But I will later this week have a video of one of his homebrewed beers, homebrewed, that he sent out to me. And it was a really awesome poblano wit that had a little bit of a touch of heat from habanero peppers that were in it. But anyway, go ahead and take another swig. am not a fast drinker, and so my videos may not, they're not going to follow the rules of the malt drinking community or anything like that. These are just the way I'm doing these videos. I'll try to drink them as fast as I can. I know a lot of times when they do their videos, they want it to be, you know, 10 minutes or less. There's all these different rules. You got to keep the label facing forward, and you got to do all these things. And that's cool and all, but like I've said in other videos, I'm really not one to follow rules too much. I kind of go my own way, do my own thing. So these videos are kind of my way of bridging the gap, I guess, between the two different worlds, between malt liquor and the craft beer community. So I'm not going to like follow rules, have this thing facing forward all the time. Trying to drink too fast usually will mess up my stomach. And for some reason, I just have a hard time burping on camera. Occasionally, I can get one or two out. But for the most part, there's nothing going on there. speaking of, there's one. Let's see. I think that was all that I really had on here so far. Flintquatch, he had said, if you like stouts, try Speedway Stout from Alesmith. I'll definitely be keeping an eye out for that one, too. I'm always looking for new ones. I actually just picked up one the other day. I really didn't need to spend any more money at the beer store. But I went back in for a second round because I brought a six-pack to a friend's house. We drank them, and I said, well, I need more beer to drink tonight. So I stopped back in, got a sixer, and he said, oh, look, I just got these three in, and one's a giant beer that I'm going to use for next week's craft beer Tall Can Tuesday. And then there was, I think, I can't remember if it's Prairie. It's something like Prairie Brewery. I don't know exactly what it is, but it's like a 13% stout, and it's a little bit decent-sized bottle. I don't think it's a 12-ounce. But that one and one other beer from that same brewery that are supposed to be really awesome. So looking forward to trying both of those as well as the big one in an upcoming video. I spent like $33 on three beers. That was just absolutely insane. That was way more than I wanted to spend. But anyway, another cool thing is I just picked up this bad boy the other day. It's nothing super special. It's not like the greatest guitar in the world. But I got it at a great deal, paid a pretty decent price for it, so I'm looking forward to jamming out a little bit. And I also picked up a new amp, which I've really been needing. So I'm not going to do a whole lot right now, but I can do all kinds of things. Maybe I'll start doing some different music videos a little bit. That was horrible. I mean, I'm a little bit buzzed, but things like... start jamming out a little bit more. So maybe if there's anything you guys want to see or hear, let me know and I can do some kind of video sometime soon. I'm just so happy to finally have a guitar back again. It's just so nice to be able to jam again. It's been a while. My amp, when my house got broken into a long time back, they stole my guitar. I got that back. I do still have it. And this is the one thing I'll put out there as a suggestion to people. Excuse me. If you're going to buy an instrument for somebody, take them with you to the store so you can kind of check them out and they can play it and feel it for themselves. Because I find with a lot of guitars... to me, and I'm so thankful because my brother got this guitar for me for my birthday a couple years ago before it was, again, stolen from my house along with a bunch of other things like my amp and stuff. And it sounds great and I love playing it, but there's just something about it. Like maybe the neck's a little too thick or, I don't know, there's something that makes it hard for me to play it. And there's a little bit of buzzing on the frets and the 1 and 2 fret up in the top on the top E string. But... you know, I think that when it comes to an instrument, if you're going to get something for somebody, let them go and pick out a few and play and kind of go from there. Because really, you know, you have to be, the person has to play the guitar and feel like that's going to be something they're going to enjoy playing. This guitar was cheap. It's way cheaper than the one my brother got me, and I love that guitar. But this one plays so much easier and smoother to my style. The neck is a little bit thinner, and it's just my fingers seem to flow. I can play on it so much easier when I'm not, you know, with a really good buzz here. So yeah, that's my only tip to you guys. If you're gonna buy an instrument for a loved one, take them with you, let them try out a few different ones, you know, within the price range that you're looking for. That, I mean, because you really, you just can't just pick out something like this for somebody and it play the way that they want it to play. They really need to kind of pick it out themselves. But anyway, that's all I got for you guys. I'm going to probably jam out for a little bit because I've got a couple hours before I need to go to bed. And I've got a good buzz kicking. So I've basically what I'm trying to do with guitar, I've played most of my life, many years, so I know how to do a lot of things. I even took a class in college, so I have a basic understanding of guitar on a technical aspect, as well as many years of reading tablature and playing on my own, and with some friends here and there, but I still just feel like I haven't really grasped it. I haven't taken this to the level that I want to, and I love playing music. I mean, playing guitar is just so much fun to me. I mean, I'm so sucked into music that has really good guitar riffs. So I'm kind of starting from the basic here, and I've gone through and I'm kind of teaching myself, guitar music theory. Again, I'm going back through from the very beginning and reteaching myself some music theory, going through, learning notes, learning the grand scale, the treble, the bass clef, all the different, you know, notes, all the way up to the 32, 64s, and the 128th notes. All of those things I'm trying to go back through and relearn, make sure I have a good understanding, the 12 fundamental tones of Western music, all of this stuff. And hopefully I'm going to start playing a whole lot better and take this to a new level. And I guess what really inspired me is when I was jamming out at work one day when I, you know, in my job, I have a lot of really awesome guitars that come through and I get a chance to play with them, you know, make sure that they're all in tune, put new strings on them and really test them out. And I had a customer, I guess, who's a big musician in the area, and he heard me jamming out, and, you know, he told the lady to go and get me, one of the girls up front, the sales lady. So when I came out front and he said, "Man, you know, heard you playing back there and it was really, really good," he said, "you should come out to one of these jam nights that they have at one of the local bars, local areas, and just come out and play." And, you know, I'm always so, like, nervous to go out and play in public. Like, I think I'm okay. I really don't think I'm that great when it comes to stuff, but people always give me compliments on how I do, and I'm a humble guy when it comes to a lot of things in life, and I really don't think I'm that great at all, excuse me, when it comes to playing guitar. I know a lot of people burp and say rugby when they do these things, but I'm going to start saying Florida 32 ounce every time I burp because that's my local homie. You know, it was such an awesome compliment to get somebody, a local musician kind of guy, tell me I should come out and jam. So I'm really wanting to take this to the next level. So I'm going to spend a lot of time practicing and playing and trying to get better and learn and see if I can really crank out some good music on this this old guitar that I picked up. But anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Again, now we're down to the swill, as they call it in the MLDC, the malt liquor drinking community. But we're going to pound this one in this video. Not too bad at all. Nice and smooth beer. I know these videos run on a lot longer than maybe some of you like. I don't know, and I don't care. This is how I do it. I'm enjoying these videos. I like that this is my opportunity to just kind of relax and do my own thing and chat with you guys, because I feel like I'm so confined in a sense when I do my food videos. And I mean, some of them, sure, I have fun, like munchies and stuff. Obviously, I get nice and baked and enjoy those videos. But when I do a lot of my reviews, I try to give a lot of respect to the companies that sent me sauces, or just even sauces that I bought. You know, I'm not going to be a complete asshole and just talk a lot of shit about a sauce that I really don't like or whatever. I just don't think that's cool. I mean, obviously people like it, and, you know, it seems like in the world, and especially in the YouTube community, if you're all negative and you have a bunch of, you know, you're just an asshole for some reason, that just seems to thrive and people really like those videos. And that's just not who I am. Like, I'm not that kind of guy. I'm all about happiness. That's why I do these videos, to have a good time, to enjoy myself, to meet new people that share similar interests. So a lot of times when people will comment something negative on my page, I'll usually delete it, or, you know, I just won't respond to it all and I'll let somebody else respond to it. I really just don't have time for all of that, for trolls and for bullshit and stuff. So, you know, might as well take that shit on somewhere else because it just doesn't float here with me. And you won't really get any response from me. But anyway, hope you guys enjoy this video. Don't forget to hit that like button. Subscribe so you don't miss out on all the different videos that I put out all week, from hot sauce reviews, beer reviews. We've got, of course, these vlogs that I have, these Tall Can Tuesdays, the munchies, sometimes some food reviews, all kinds of random cool stuff. And hope you guys enjoy what I do. And as always, stay toasty, my friends.